Which app has been launched for athletes? Answer is NADA app. This app has been launched by Sports Minister Kiran Rijiju. This app is a National Anti-Doping Agency's first mobile app. This app will provide information about prohibited substances. NADA app aims to create bridge between athletes and NADA by providing easily accessible information on various aspects of sports. Next, who has launched Har Ghar Jal campaign? Answer is Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath. This campaign is related to pipe water to every house. Bundelkhand and Vindhya regions will be covered by this project in the first phase about a cost of Rs. 2185 crores. A population of 14 lakh will be benefited from the project. Next, Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana has been extended till which month? Answer is November 2020. Under this scheme, free food grains will be provided to 80 crore people across the country for 5 more months. 5 kg of wheat or rice along with 1 kg chana will be provided to every family per month. The entire cost of this initiative will cost over Rs. 90,000 crores. Next, Madhya Pradesh state has launched which campaign to maintain academic regularity of students during COVID-19 crisis? Answer is Hamara Ghar Hamara Vidyalaya campaign. The scheme provides a school-like environment for the children taught at home through online classes. The campaign has been prepared by State Department of Education. The scheme has been started from 6 July 2020. Next, which institute has been prepared and offered world's first ever online BSc degree in programming and data science? Answer is IIT Madras. HRD Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal has launched this program. Data science is one of the fastest growing sector that is predicted to create 11.5 million jobs by 2026. This program is open to anyone who has passed class 12. Next, who has developed an AI-based deep learning tool for detection of COVID-19? Answer is IIT Gandhinagar. The tool is developed by Pushpal Singh Yadav. This artificial intelligence-based deep learning tool is developed for detection of COVID-19 from chest X-ray images, which can be used for quick preliminary diagnosis before the medical test. Next, who has launched the E-Kisan Dhan app for farmers all over India? Answer is HDFC Bank. Through mobile phones, farmers will be able to access the services both banking and agriculture. E-Kisan Dhan will provide services like mandi prices, latest farming news, weather forecast, information on seed varieties, SMS advisory, e-Pashu Hat, Kisan TV, etc. This app will also help with multiple banking services. Next, which project has been announced by the Kerala government for the overall development of the state? Answer is Dream Kerala project. This project is related to tap the potential and experience of those returning from abroad and other states after losing their jobs due to COVID-19 pandemic. Next, who has launched Accelerate Vigyan scheme answer is the Science and Engineering Research Board. It will provide a single platform for capacity building programs, research internships, and workshops across the country. The primary objective of the scheme is to encourage high-end scientific research and to prepare scientific manpower that can lead to research careers and knowledge-based economy. Next, which state has been declared as disturbed area for 6 months? Answer is Nagaland. The center has declared the entire Nagaland as the disturbed area for a 6 month till December end 2020. The whole Nagaland is in such a disturbed and dangerous condition that the use of armed forces in aid of the civil power is necessary. It has been declared disturbed for 6 months with effects from 13 June 2020. Next, Indore Municipal Corporation is placing dustbins of which color at all major places in the city to prevent corona infection? Answer is yellow dustbins. This is the third dustbin apart from blue and green colors dustbin and being placed only for corona infected material. Indore is possibly the first city to place a separate dustbin for the corona residual. Next, which state has announced a monthly stipend of rupees 3000 to junior lawyers? Answer is Tamil Nadu. Monthly stipend for 2 years to help them overcome financial difficulties. It is running an advocate welfare scheme for more than 3 decades. Under the scheme, on the demise of the advocates, currently 7 lakh rupees each is being given to the families. This stipend is additional measure to the family. Next, who has launched the toolkit for Swachh Sarvekshan 2021? Answer is Hardeep Singh Puri. Hardeep Singh Puri has launched the toolkit for Swachh Sarvekshan 2021. He is a Minister of State for Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. It is the 6th edition of the annual cleanliness survey of Urban India. Next, All India Radio broadcast its first ever news magazine program in which language? Answer is Sanskrit. The program titled Sanskrit Saptahiki will be of 20 minutes duration and can be heard on every Saturday with a repeat broadcast on Sundays. Next, who has developed a wearable dub pulse that is meant to alert users to avoid face touch? Answer is NASA. The round pendant is worn around your neck and when you raise your hand towards head, it will vibrate, reminding you to stop. The idea is to help people curb the spread of coronavirus. Next, which bank has joined the Central Banks and Supervisors Network for greening the financial system? Answer is the Asian Development Bank. ADB has joined the NGFS as an observer on 23rd June 2020. NGFS was launched at the Paris One Planet Summit on December 12, 2017. Next, which company has cancelled trade deals worth 900 crores rupees with China? Answer is Hero Cycles. Hero Cycles chairman and managing director Pankaj Munjal said the company has boycotted Chinese companies and decided not to do any trade with Chinese in future. The company is now looking for opportunities in other countries and planning to set up the plant of Hero Cycles in Germany. Next, who has launched Atmanirbhar Bharat App Innovation Challenge? Answer is Prime Minister Narendra Modi. The Innovation Challenge aims at encouraging tech and startup communities to create world-class Made in India apps. Under this challenge, innovators are invited to develop apps in 8 categories. The App Innovation Challenge has been launched in the combined partnership of the Ministry of Electronics and IT and Atal Innovation Mission, Niti Aayog. Next, who has launched India's first social media super application? Answer is Vice President Venkaiah Naidu. The app was created by more than 1000 IT professionals. The app is available in 8 languages. It has been created with the user's privacy as priority. The app allows users to stay in touch through a vibrant feed, free audio or video calls, and private or group chats. Next, DRDO is going to establish a research cell at which institute? Answer is IIT Hyderabad. This cell is going to establish to meet the future defense technological requirements of the country by understanding basic and applied research programs. Some of its trust areas include quantum technologies, sensors for defense application, etc. Next, CBSC has reduced the syllabus up to how much percentage for class 9 to 12? Answer is 30%. Syllabus is reduced to make up for the academic loss during COVID-19 lockdown. Considering importance of learning achievements, it has been decided to rationalize syllabus by retaining the core concepts. CBSC was advised to revise the curriculum looking at the situation in the world. Next, Maharashtra CM Uddhav Thackeray inaugurated how many jumbo COVID care centers in Mumbai? Answer is 4. These care centers spread across Mulund, Dahisar, Mahalakshmi Racecourse and Bandra Kurla complex in Mumbai. A total of 3,520 beds have been added to Mumbai's capacity, including 222 ICU beds. The facility has been built with the help of City and Industrial Development Corporation. Next, which bank has announced the launch of saving account scheme for minor? Answer is Fino Payments Bank Limited. This scheme is for minors aged between 10 to 18 years. Bhavishya, a subscription-based saving account, can be opened by paying a nominal amount. The bank will be initially introduce the Bhavishya saving account in Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and Madhya Pradesh and gradually in other states. Next, which country has formally notified the United Nations of its decision to withdraw it from WHO? Answer is United States of America. In April 2020, US stopped funding to WHO as the Trump administration review the ties. The US is the largest funder to the World Health, contributing more than $450 million per annum. The US has accused WHO of siding with China on the outbreak of the virus, which originated in Chinese city of Wuhan in late 2019. The US has been a party to a WHO constitution since 21st June 1948. Next, who has initiated a skill development program in Andaman and Nicobar Islands? Answer is Construction Industry Development Council. It will provide employment-oriented training and skill development for the marginalized section. Next, who has inaugurated 6 new bridges built by Border Roads Organization? Answer is Defense Minister Rajnath Singh. Bridges are constructed in border areas of Jammu and Kashmir. The total cost of construction of the bridge was rupees 43 crores. 4 bridges are constructed in Akhnoor sector and 2 bridges are in Kathua district. Next, what is the theme of World Population Day 2020? Answer is how to safeguard the health and rights of women and girls now amid the pandemic. World Population Day is celebrated on 11 July every year in order to spread and raise awareness of the rising global population issues. Next, which state has launched a massive sanitization drive across the state? Answer is Uttar Pradesh government on 11 July 2020. UP is under series of restriction of a period of 55 hours since 10 July 2020. Next, which state has signed an MOU with Flipkart to promote the state's arts, crafts and handloom sector? Answer is Karnataka MSME and Mines Department. It will bring them onto e-commerce and market access. This partnership will help in taking the local handicrafts and handloom business of the Karnataka to a national consumer base. Next, which state has launched 8 technology-driven solutions under 5T initiative for Home and General Administration Department? Answer is Odisha. Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik has launched these technology solutions. The technology solutions for public services launch include Bhuvaneshwar Land Use Intelligence System, E-Pravesh, E-Bhavan, E-Atithi, etc. Who has launched the ATL app development module for school children across the country? Answer is Niti Aayog's Atal Innovation Mission. The ATL app is an online course which is completely free. Through 6 project-based learning modules and online mentoring sessions, young innovators can learn to build mobile apps in various Indian languages and showcase their talent. To build capacities and acumen for app development within the school teachers, periodic teacher training sessions will be conducted on AIM app development course. Next, India's first ever e-lok adalat was held in which state? Answer is Chhattisgarh. The session was inaugurated by Chief Justice of Chhattisgarh High Court, Justice P.R. Ramachandra Menon. About 195 benches were constituted at different phases of the state via video conferencing. 3,135 cases were identified for compromise. In all, 2,270 cases were settled in a single day through virtual mode. Next, Google will invest how many billion dollars in India as a part of company's Google for India initiative? Answer is $10 million, around 75,000 crore rupees, over the next 5 to 7 years with the aim on digitizing the economy and building India's first product and services. Google will do this through a mix of equity investments, partnership and operational infrastructure and ecosystem investments. Next, which country has become the first to complete clinical trials of COVID-19 vaccine on humans? Answer is Russia. The results are proven the medication's effectiveness. The research has been completed and it proved that the vaccine is safe. The volunteers will be discharged on July 15 and July 20. Russia has allowed clinical trials of two forms of potential COVID-19 vaccine. Next, where has been designed a post-COVID coach to fight COVID-19? Answer is Rail Coach Factory at Kapurthala. Indian Railways has developed a COVID coach. This coach is designed with hands-free amenities, copper-coated handrails and latches, plasma air purification and titanium dioxide coating for COVID-free passenger journey. Next, who has announced guidelines for online classes operationalized by schools? Answer is HRD Ministry. HRD Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank has virtually released the Pragyata guidelines on digital education. The guidelines recommended a cap on a screen time for students. Next, which bank has appointed Election Commissioner Ashok Lavasa as its vice president? Answer is the Asian Development Bank. He will succeed Divakar Gupta, whose term will end on August 31st. Next, Bharti Airtel and Verizon has announced a strategic alliance to introduce enterprise-grade video conferencing in India. Bharti Airtel will offer secure enterprise-grade video conferencing solutions under the brand name Airtel BlueJeans. This will help people to communicate and collaborate across mobile, desktop, browser and conference rooms. Next, the most affordable COVID-19 test kit produced by which IIT? Answer is IIT Delhi. HRD Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank and Minister of State Sanjay Dhotre has launched the COVID-19 test kit. It has been manufactured by New Tech Medical under the name CoroSure. Next, which airport is offering fully contactless airport car parking service? Answer is GMR Hyderabad International Airport. The authority has scaled up its NETC FASTag car parking in collaboration with NPCI. The airport has added a high standard of safety with contactless toll transactions during the ongoing COVID-19 situation. Next, which institute has developed a portable hospital? Answer is IIT Madras. The portable hospital unit can be installed anywhere within 2 hours by 4 people, called Medicab. Its decentralized approach to detect, screen, identify, isolate and treat COVID-19 patients in their local communities through these portable units. It has been recently launched in Vayanad district of Kerala. Next, in which state COVID wards to be created in 6 jails? Answer is Madhya Pradesh. It will be created in 6 central jails across the state, including Bhopal, Gwalior, Indore, Ujjain, Jabalpur and Sagar. A decision has been taken to extend the parole period by 60 days by Home Minister Dr. Narottam Mishra. Next, which state has launched fertilizer distribution program? Answer is Uttar Pradesh. Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath has launched the urea and other fertilizer distribution program for the farmers in the state. This will provide awareness and availability of the adequate urea in Uttar Pradesh and Bihar. The program is headed by Hindustan Fertilizer and Chemicals Limited. Next, which state has decided to convert waste generated in the state to electricity? Answer is Uttarakhand. This initiative titled Waste to Energy. At present, 900 tons of waste is generated in the hill state every day. This scheme also aims to solve unavailability of landfills to dispose of the solid waste across the hill state, which has 10 out of 13 districts as hill areas. Next, which companies of Surat have developed a high quality ventilator at a low cost? Answer is DRC Techno and InnoSeed. They have developed this ventilator under Making India scheme. They have taken inspiration from Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan and to tackle this difficult situation of COVID-19. This ventilators having all the features which an international company's ventilators possesses. Next, all capitals of northeastern states will be connected to the rail network by which year? Answer is 2023. Work to connect capitals of Manipur, Mizoram, Nagaland and Meghalaya is in progress. Project is targeted to be completed by December 2022. Next, which government has launched monthly pension for the keen of the Asha and Anganwadi workers dying during COVID-19 duty? Answer is Odisha. Family members of deceased Anganwadi workers will get ₹7,500 and keen of deceased Asha workers will get ₹5,000. Next, which company has launched generic version of Remdesivir? Answer is Mylan. Mylan has launched generic version of Remdesivir under the brand name Desram in India for treatment of COVID-19 patients. The drug is approved for the treatment of suspected or laboratory confirmed incidences of COVID-19 in adults and children hospitalized with severe presentations of diseases. Mylan will manufacture Desram in its injectable facility in Bangalore. Next, who virtually inaugurated the first mega food park in Mizoram? Answer is Food Processing Minister Harsimrat Kaur Badal. The park will benefit farmers, growers, processors, consumers and prove to be big boost to the growth of the food processing sector in the northeast region. It will provide direct and indirect employment to 5,000 people and benefit around 25,000 farmers. Next, which state has issued revised discharge policy for patients who have recovered from COVID-19 infection? Answer is Uttar Pradesh. State Health Department has reviewed this policy. Dedicated website upcovid19tracks.in has been developed to track the information about patients. Next, who has been warned people against the use of N95 masks with respirator valves in them? Answer is Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. The Director General of Health Services Dr. Rajiv Garg said that the use of valve respirator N95 mask is detrimental to the measures adopted for preventing the spread of coronavirus as it does not prevent the virus from escaping out of the mask. Next, who has launched a free online portal called Pravasi Rozgar? Answer is Actor Sonu Sood. Actor Sonu Sood launched the app to help migrants find job opportunities in various sectors across the country. The online platform has over 500 reputed companies offering job opportunities. Next, who has launched India's first numberless card? Answer is FamPay. With FamPay and its memberless card, minors, teenagers can now make online and offline payments without the need to set up a bank account. Next, which government is going to start self-test system? Answer is Uttar Pradesh, so that anyone can go and get himself tested. UP is now on second number in country in terms of COVID testing. Next, who has issued the formal government sanction letter for grant of permanent commission to women officers in the Indian Army? Answer is the Ministry of Defence. This will prove the way for empowering women officers to shoulder larger roles in the organization. The order specifies grant of PC to short service commission women officers in all 10 streams of the Indian Army. Next, which app has been launched फॉर कॉन्टैक्टलेस टिकट चेकिंग एट द छत्रपति शिवाजी महाराज टर्मिनस इन मुंबई आंसर इज चेक इन मास्टर द सेंट्रल रेलवे मुंबई डिवीजन हैज लॉन्च द ऐप हैज OCR and QR code scanning features to check PRS and UTS tickets from a safe distance. Next, India's second national level plasma bank was opened in which state? Answer is Tamil Nadu at a cost of Rs. 2.34 crores after New Delhi. It has been opened with the approval of Indian Council of Medical Research. Next, India's first honey testing laboratory has been set up in which state? Answer is Gujarat. It is located at National Dairy Development Board in Anand district. The new lab will test honey as per the norms specified by the Food Safety Regulator FSSAI. The purity of honey, adulteration, chemical substances, residues, heavy metal or antibodies can be checked.